In this video, I'll show you how to use scientific notation in MCAT-style questions without a calculator when it comes to addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. When it comes to adding and subtracting exponents, as long as you're dealing with the same power, all you have to do is add or subtract the coefficient
and keep the power. So for example, say you're given 4.7 times 10 to the minus 3 plus 2.3 times 10 to the minus 3. Both numbers in question are times 10 to the minus 3, so all we have to do is add 4.7 and 2.3.
We'll start with the coefficients.
4 and 2 is 6, 0.7 and 0.3 is 1, gives us a total of 7.0 times 10 to the minus 3. 10 to the minus 3 hasn't changed, and all I did was add the two numbers. When the powers are not the same, but they're close enough, you want to turn them into the same power and then treat it the same way. Let's keep it simple. Say I have 5 times 10 to the minus 3 plus 6 times 10 to the minus 4. I can't simply add 5 and 6 because I'm dealing with different powers. So what I want to do is turn the first number into a power of negative 4 or the second number into a power of negative 3. In an earlier video, I showed you a trick for multiplying and dividing by a factor of 10 by simply moving the decimal. You can find that video along with my entire MCAT Math Without a Calculator series on my website layoversci.com/MCATMath. Scientific notation is simply another way to represent powers of 10, and if I treat it that way, the trick of moving the decimal still applies. If I have a number like 10 to the minus 3, the way to make this 10 to the minus 4 is to divide it by 10. Now remember the trick I showed you. If I have an example and I do times 10 divided by 10, I don't change the identity of the example. So if I take 10 to the minus 3 and divide that by 10, I get 10 to the minus 4. I have to justify that by multiplying this number by 10. 5 times 10 is 50. Changing 5 times 10 to the minus 3 to be 50 times 10 to the minus 4 has the same exact value. Now that I have 50 times 10 to the minus 4, I can add that to 6 times 10 to the minus 4 because they have the same power. 50 plus 6 is 56, and we still keep 10 to the minus 4. Now, in typical scientific notation, you want just one number immediately followed by a decimal. So I have to do that times 10 divided by 10 again, or simply think of it as when I decrease the number, meaning I move the tens place or the decimal one space to the left, I increase my exponent value. So 56 divided by 10 is 5.6. 10 to the minus 4 times 10 is 10 to the minus 3. In other words, I use that trick again of times 10 divided by 10 and quickly got my answer. So the final answer for this question is 5.6 times 10 to the minus 3. Multiplication of exponents may show up on your MCAT in a question like this. Find the NO3 minus concentration when 6.8 times 10 to the minus 7 moles of NaNO3 are added to 5.1 times 10 to the minus 3 liters of H2O. Finding molarity is a topic that will be discussed in the chemistry series at layoversci.com/MCATchemistry, but for now let's focus on the math. We want to solve for molarity, which is moles per liter. Pulling the numbers out of the question, we get an equation that looks like this. 6.8 times 10 to the minus 7 divided by 5.1 times 10 to the minus 3. This throws off so many students because they make it harder than it has to. So let's talk about the rules, then let's solve the problem. When it comes to multiplication, all you do is multiply your number and then add the exponents. In this case, we have 2 times 4, which is 8. For the exponents 10 to the 4th and 10 to the 2nd, we add 4 and 2, which is 6, giving us an answer of 8 times 10 to the 6th. For division, you divide your numbers and then subtract your exponents. In this case, we have 3 times 10 to the 6th divided by 6 times 10 to the 3rd. We'll set that up as follows. 3 divided by 6, that's 3 over 6.
Simplify that to 1 over 2, which is 0.5.
This is a fraction that you have to know. If you don't know it yet, grab my MCAT math guide on my website, layoversci.com/MCATmath. Next, we subtract the exponents. We have 10 to the 6th and 10 to the 3rd. 6 minus 3 is 3,
giving me an answer of 0.5 times 10 to the 3rd.
Now, this is not proper scientific notation, so we'll actually move the decimal one space to the right, multiplying by 10, and decrease the exponent by one number, which is essentially dividing by 10. In other words, we're multiplying and dividing by 10,
giving me an actual answer of 5 times 10 to the 2nd, which is simply 500.
Now back to our question. For a question like this, the MCAT is not looking for an exact value. Instead, they're looking for something close enough, and you'll typically see answers that have the powers all over the place. So we're looking for an approximate number, but the correct power. The power in this case is 10 to the minus 7 divided by 10 to the minus 3. So we have 7 minus negative 3. Negative 7 minus negative 3 minus negative cancels out, so it's really negative 7 plus 3, giving me a new exponent of 10 to the minus 4. The numbers themselves, 6.8 is approximately 7, 5.1 is approximately 5, so we have 7 over 5 times 10 to the minus 4. This is not an appropriate answer, and in the next video, I'll break down fractions and ratios in more detail, but for now, look at it this way. 7 over 5 is really 5 over 5 plus 2 over 5. 5 over 5 is 1, so we have 1 and 2 over 5 times 10 to the minus 4. 2 over 5 is a fraction you should recognize, because 1 over 5 is 0.2, therefore 2 over 5 is 0.4. This gives us a final answer of 1.4 times 10 to the minus 4. Punching the initial numbers into the calculator, I got 1.33 times 10 to the minus 4, which on the MCAT is close enough.
Be sure to join me in the next video, where I show you how to tackle squares and square roots when it comes to the MCAT. MCATExamStrategy.com